When you hear about the size of the opportunity in our market, you know, what comes to your mind as someone who is already playing in the space?
The size of the opportunity in the market is something that really gear us up to know that what we're doing, we're on the right path. $10 billion opportunity per year is huge, right? And for us, is to tap into that opportunity and be able to create value within that opportunity.
So what are we seeing that much traction on investment flows in our region, in our country, especially compared to other markets?
When you look at it, the East Africa in the last couple of years, they have a lot of investment in East Africa. So the money that goes into that market is growing. But then people are now focusing more majorly on Nigeria, right? $10 billion opportunity in Nigeria. People are moving to Nigeria to be able to invest in Nigeria and be able to see. We see significant investment. We recently, the World Bank approved for $350 million for the Rural Electrification Agency, you know, to deploy solar home system and large solar home system and their mini grid in the country. We've also seen African Development Bank getting interested in this space, you know, to be able to do much more product, much more things they are doing in this space. So we've seen several other organizations, international organizations, we've seen international donors, organizations coming into this space. Local banks are getting more interested. And that's very good things to know. So local banks are getting more interested. And we've seen the VC firms and the private equity firm getting more interested into this space in the last couple of months.
Interesting. But as someone who's been in the space for a while, you've been in renewable energy business in Nigeria for a bit, can you speak to the comparative advantage that Nigeria has?
Yeah, well, just like we all know, we have the population. And there are more than 80 million Nigerians are not connected to the grid. They don't have energy access. So that's a huge opportunity. There are over 130 gigawatts of suppressed demand in the country right now, especially for small and medium-scale enterprise. So that's a big opportunity. So we have a comparative advantage in the terms of the demand is there, the pent-up demand is there. So we, as a private sector player, so we are pushing ourselves into that demand.
Would you say that the national strategy is taking advantage of these advantages?
Yeah. The government have done, since 2015, they have started with the National Renewable Energy Policy. So they have that. And as at now, they have mini-grid regulations, which even though they still have some hiccups, but it can be resolved, right? The strategy is in the line what it should be. Even though there are some challenges in terms of regulatory, right? There's still some regulatory challenges, I must tell you. On the part of players, there are some operational issues that need to be resolved.
So I would really like you to just talk a little more about some of those challenges you're seeing from the regulation side, because it really impacts how the business can scale up.
Yeah, so we saw that at the beginning of the year, there's a tariff systems that need to be placed. A tariff system, for instance, when you're importing your product from abroad, there's a tariff that's supposed to be on solar panel in particular. Right, then what we have seen is that we have seen flip-flop in terms of what is on ground and what the customer actually charging. That's one of those things. The other one is around the tariff that you eventually charge to the end customer. It's not cost reflective as it is. Even for mini grid regulation, it's still not cost reflective. So those are challenges. There are challenges, but it's also an opportunity for us as a nation to look at it and be able to resolve those challenges.
Well, if you say the power sector generally, the cost-reflective tariffs have always been a problem, even for the national grid, from the national grid, and even from the discos. The discos will tell you a lot more on that one. But even with the current tariffs as they are, how commercially viable is it?
The good thing is this: when you talk of off-grid, we already have demand. People are already using small-size generator. 14 gigawatts of generator small-scale generator have been used in Nigeria. So people are already paying more than what they're actually paying. For instance, they're paying like 140 naira per kilowatt hour. So as off-grid is charging less than 140 naira per kilowatt hour. So that makes it to be more attractive for the consumer.
Okay. So speaking on innovation, I understand that you're doing a pay-as-you-go payment system. How is that playing out and what's the reception like for?
Yeah, the good thing is this. We've looked at the Nigerian market. So, early we used to see people coughing out like $10,000 to be able to afford solar solutions. So, what we have put in place is to put an IoT solution, a technology-based solution, such that people could be able to pay over a period of time. And then our target verticals like the SMEs, the healthcare. So because we are aggressively looking at the market that need our products. So our target vertical, SMEs, the retail outlets, the hospitals, the clinics that need those things, the educational system. So we're actually deploying those solutions to them, and we're turning their CapEx to OpEx. So that way, they will be able to pay over a period of time. So it's not that you are going to cover $10,000 or cover $15,000 to acquire solar solution. So you pay as you use basis. Yeah.
You mentioned earlier about energy access and being a problem, and I can imagine the work you do. You work a lot of rural farmers. How is that playing out?
Yeah, so there are two things in Nigeria context. So you see a lot of people talking about energy access, but what of energy reliability? So that's an issue around energy reliability. Of course, 80 million people does not have energy access. So what about other people who have to have energy reliability? For instance, 239 hours are being lost every month for power outage for small businesses, and that results to more like 7% of the revenue. So how do we make sure that this does not happen? So those are the things that we're doing.
Interesting, interesting. But what are the problems you face when in trying to scale up some of the solutions that you have?
So the problem, one, infrastructure is not there. In terms of distribution network, it's not there. So you have to possibly have to build the internet first before you build the Google. So for us, infrastructure is very key to what we're doing in terms of mobility distribution systems. Two, finance. So in the other years, what we have seen is that people have not been able to say, okay, it's too risky. They say off-grid is too risky. But now, people are now getting on board and saying, okay, this is something I can put my money into it and I can have a multiple of returns over the years.